Hi there, Petrea O'Donoghue, psychologist. I've just spent an evening with three of my friends who I've been friends now for over three decades. We met as students in our psychology days, and our friendship has endured over those years, and I feel incredibly blessed to have such wonderful women in my life and to have had them in my life for such a long time. I know that there are many people who don't have long friendships, and certainly not a group of friends that have lasted decades. So for me, I feel that that is such a powerful kind of legacy from our uni days to kind of continue to have that in our life, and that I know will continue to be there in my life. And the power of that is that really looks at one of the key human drivers that gets mentioned in theories of motivations. One of the most well-known ones is Maslow's hierarchy of needs, when he wrote in A Theory of Human Motivation back in 1943, and the middle layer of his hierarchy was love and belonging, and that's all about the friendships we have. Obviously, the core or the base level of needs that he spoke about was around our basic physiological needs, then our safety needs, then our love and friendship or love and belonging, and then our esteem needs, which comes from a sense of accomplishment, and then moving on to self-actualization, where we really are being generative and creative in what it is that we're doing in order to really fulfill our potential. And another theory of motivation, self-determination theory, also has as one of its foundational cores is that sense of connection. So self-determination theory has three core elements, which are looking at a sense of autonomy, competence, and relatedness, that sense of belonging. So in some very core theories of human motivation, that sense of belonging and connection and being able to relate to people or having that relatedness is so foundational. And I know that for me, it's certainly been a very enriching part of my life. And so where in your life are you able to cultivate those friendships? Perhaps there are some friendships you have that you could tend to and cultivate and grow a little bit more. Perhaps you need to expand your friendships. Perhaps you need to prune some of your friendships. But perhaps you need to, find a way to enrich the friendships you have. Maybe you need to see some more often, some less often. But friendships are, as humans, we are social creatures, and being able to find a group of people who share similar values, on a similar pathway, and who you enjoy being with is just such an important part of our personal life journey. So I hope you have enriching friendships in your life, and may they long continue, especially as we embark upon a new decade about to begin. Anyway, thank you for listening.